So I'm sure you have been to the hospital and you have met a doctor who was rude, who didn't care, who took very little time for you, who basically came, did the necessary things, gave you the obligatory 16 seconds that they say for the patient-doctor conversation, and then left. I mean, we all have these doctors. They're a bright example of how people are. And it's also part of the course of the medical system in the society, but this is the way it basically is. Now, let's take all the specialists.
Make a comment.
A comment, but yeah. Not a question, please.
Yeah, not a question, not a comment. Because, of course, every one of us met this kind of a doctors, but most of the time, I don't think it's because they're so successful and so great. Most of the time, it's because of...
No.
Because of,
But we are talking about the character of the doctor. We're all saying, all right, we have heard that, but still, a patient comes to you, he is sick, or he's already in a bad or negative state. So why should you as a doctor be more provoking while you are the profession that's supposed to care and supposed to deliver some help? So this is the main thing that we're trying to say.
Perhaps, perhaps if we would drag a little longer with this discussion just to make an, let's say,
statement.
Well, to compare it to an everyday situation, let's say that you meet a person in the street, perhaps in this country, though I don't have any special things with this state, this country, you see a person who has a lot of money, let's say, you can see by the clothes, by the car, and this person perhaps will be in a certain way which makes you think, aha, this person has just, or is newly rich due to certain perhaps behavior. So when we discuss a medical doctor, we're not discussing a certain or a general behavior of this character, but actually specific people. So we'll continue it now, just to perhaps clarify a little bit what was there.
So what happens to all of us after some time, that's a sad truth, or to most of us that feel this way, is that we start falling for the financial aspect of the job. And that is a period for some people that passes, but for some people this period remains and they continue in this way. And let's take House from TV, right? We all know House, a lot of us are watching the series. You saw in the intro when he came to his patient and he said, wow, you are ugly. I mean, imagine a doctor coming to you and saying that. Kind of a controversy to what actually means.
I'm used to it.
It's what happened when you were born.
So. I think the house is being based on doctors' behaviors. Not maybe exactly like this, but I think there's a certain way there is people like that for sure. So, let's look at it. He is. Who is house? He's bossy. He is basically a huge child who only cares for his own needs and his food and looking at girls and all these things. But still, at the same time, he manages to always somehow, with luck or with knowledge, to find a mystical cure. Of course, it's dramatized on the television, but let's look at the realistic point, the realistic person of this. He's somebody who is extremely successful and well-known. We all can agree. People know him throughout the medical world. And still, if you look at his lifestyle and if you look at his behavior, he's not the rich millionaire type VIP plastic surgeon character. And we ask ourselves, why is that? Why is that?
What we want to clear out here, because I think once again, some people think that the house here, we're talking about person. We're not. Just to clarify, we're not talking about the actual character, we're talking about the situation which upon he is, that who is this person? A person perhaps that, due to the success, has become somebody who people see in a different way, right? So if you look at a person who has achieved a lot of things, he has a lot of respect, perhaps, from his colleagues, or what else can we see? We can see jealousy, yes? What else? We can see a certain way, a pattern, I would say, behavior, which will be more and more showing as far as the success progresses. So, we can continue with that.
So, ask yourself the question,
house, movies or Mad Men?
Movies.
Sometimes the difference is not so far from each other.
Not more, not less.
I'm picturing Michael walking into the room and saying, "Oh, you are ugly." And there is a person that is actually
I think that based on the point of psychological thing on movies, like.
Okay, but it's possible. Movies are based on real human psychology.
No.
Yes.
No. It's not possible. It's endangering your place of work. It's endangering your patient. You're ugly or stupid or whatever.
But let's see the difference.
No, but personal opinion, the connection sex, power, and glory to money. Because the only thing I can read here is money, 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 money. The only thing you talk about is money.
I talk about money now. I don't. But let's think about it. There are doctors that think that there is a curing and caring combination. So if you care, you cure. And there is doctors, for example, like this character who doesn't think so. And still, when it comes to an important decision, he shows that he does care. He suggests the kind of treatment that would actually save a life and not make the person prettier or therefore. So that again shows the character that when it needs to be, he really shows his real opinion, if you like it or not. Because not all the time we like to have a choice between two things and one thing doesn't seem so appealing. So all of this being said, you can say that House is basically a ideal or unideal character, which is pure, because he doesn't try to be somebody who he's not. The only thing that he tries to show is that he's not miserable, which he obviously is, but that is his own personal affliction. So we come to the closing point. Some people here will agree, some people will not agree. We still ask you to listen to the conclusion is that we believe that we all of us have the two or more types of doctors in ourselves, either the egoistic type with the genius or without, or the caring type that actually really wants to help out, and which I believe that many people here have. And let's not forget the human side, because we all human, we all have all our mistakes and our flaws. And we would ask to think that you should try to be all that you can be as a student, as a son, as a daughter, for your family, for the people that you love, and later on, especially for your patients. And I think that they will be thankful for it. And that when you go home, you will not think how much money you have in your bank, but you'll actually think that you can make the world a better place. That's, is there any main questions that we need to be discussed now, because our time is running?